Nancy Bird-Walton will forever be known in history as Australia's youngest female commercial pilot. She is significant not only because of her contribution to Australia's aviation history, but also for the way in which she used her knowledge and experience to support those less fortunate than herself and inspire many young women and to save lives. Her legacy has changed not only Australia's past history, but also the present and future of aviation. She smelled a daisy, she smelled a daisy. Born in October 1915 in New South Wales, Nancy Bird-Walton wanted to fly from before she could even properly pronounce the word aeroplane. So after school, she moved to Sydney to begin flying lessons at Sir Charles Kingsford Smith's Flying School, despite her parents' disapproval and the stigma of women's roles and inabilities at the time.
Some of the doctors wouldn't fly with a woman.
So in a little over a month, Nancy earned her A license and then her advanced A license soon after. Before she knew it, she was Australia's youngest commercial licensed female pilot at only 19 years old. But instead of devoting her time to breaking world records, Nancy Bird-Walton helped to set up a flying ambulance and a baby clinic service. It was dangerous and lonely, especially for a young woman in her 20s, and was certainly not as glamorous as breaking records. Nancy's sacrifice for others and perseverance was a great achievement in itself that made a great impact in Australian history. Nancy also wanted to save lives during World War II, even though no women pilots were allowed to fly in the war. Deflated that she couldn't help, she became commandant of Women's Air Training Corps of Australia instead, in hopes that a women's auxiliary air force would be established. Nancy Bird-Walton was not only charitable in war efforts and for the well-being of Australians, but also competitive, winning the Ladies' Trophy in 1936. In 1950, Bird-Walton also formed the Australian Women's Pilot Association and became its president. She then went on to be the first woman from overseas to compete in several of the all-women powder puff derbies in the United States. Even after she retired, Nancy still broadened her legacy in Australia's history. She published her autobiographies, Born to Fly, in 1961, and My God, It's a Woman, in 1990, which had inspired many young Australian women and helped to challenge the role of women. Nancy Bird-Walton was awarded the Order of the British Empire in 1966 and the Order of Australia in 1990, as a result of her incredibly generous spirit. Australia's airline Qantas also named its first Airbus A380 in it her name, the year before she died at 93 years old. Although a woman's place was considered to be in the home and nowhere near aviation, Nancy still pursued her dream. Her achievements and her mere presence in the field of aviation changed the future for women in Australia. She gave inspiration for women to pursue their dreams and proved that women could fly and work in aviation just as well as men can. Because of her, women are now working as airline captains, search and rescue pilots, and are currently serving as pilots in the Australian Air Force and Navy. The Australian Women Pilots Association that she established is also still running today. It has encouraged women from all over Australia to pursue dreams similar to what Nancy Bird-Walton had. Nancy Walton also put the minds of many people more at rest and saved lives while working in a flying ambulance. While some women did fly as a hobby, she was the one who used her license to actually make a difference in Australian history and in people's lives.